to Keto Food Made Easy. Today we're making dessert. I'm very excited about it. I just created in my head the recipe and now I'm gonna actually make it. I'm so happy. This is gonna be chocolate fudge, so pay attention. First you need to have a double boiler. I'm already boiling up a hot water here. It started to bubble a little bit. But all we need is really a steam. So we're making double boiler with a pot of water and then just put your bowl, glass bowl on it and start adding the ingredients. The first thing I'm gonna add is gonna be sugar-free chocolate. I find this in the kosher store. Chocolate bars. I'm gonna add two of them. Just break them down so it can melt faster. I used to work in Israel, and this was the chocolate we ate all the time. But that time I ate it with sugar, now I'm just eating it without sugar. So I'm just gonna melt the chocolate here. You can lower a little bit to medium heat. Just gonna open the other bar. Gonna be very easy, no bake fudge. First thing we add is the chocolate, let it sit here, melt a little bit. The next thing I'm adding to it is a whole stick of butter, which is half cup of butter, unsalted. Make sure it's unsalted, we don't want to have salt in it for now. Just wait for the chocolate and the butter melt together. Start stirring it when you see it's melting on the bottom. It's gonna take a few minutes. I'm gonna stir them together because I see already it's melting. Add your next ingredient, which is gonna be vanilla extract. You don't need much, just a little. About a teaspoon. Start to smell really good. Don't let it burn. If you see it's melting very fast, then just lower your heat again, because we just want to melt all the ingredients together and make it smooth. when your chocolate is almost all melted, I found this in the store the other day, and it seems like a really, really good idea to incorporate into it. So this one have not much carbs, that's why I chose it, and it's gonna be very nutty flavor. And then in the end, I'm gonna also add pieces of cashews. So now I'm just adding about, stir it up a little bit because the top is very oily. I'm just adding about 2 to 3 tablespoons of this mixture butter to make our chocolate fudge nutty. And I'm pretty sure it's gonna be delicious. So I added about 3 tablespoons. Has little pieces of nuts, little sweet. It has a little bit of salt, so I'm not adding any more salt into my chocolate because that's gonna be enough for the flavor. One more thing to add, that's gonna be instant coffee. I also like this kosher coffee, Nescafe. Don't use regular coffee, just use Nescafe, please. Because I don't want to have a coffee flavor really, really strong in this one. I'm adding only 1 teaspoon. You know, the cooperate chocolate with coffee many, many times. So that's to get all the flavors nicely. Look, my chocolate is all melted. I'm gonna turn off the heat now. Beautiful, creamy. I already have my chocolate resting here for about 10 minutes, and I roughly chopped up some cashews. This is the bag I used. It has sea salt in it, just a tiny bit, not a lot. So now I'm gonna add my chopped cashews into my form just to have some decorations on the, this is gonna be actually the top of the chocolate fudge. But I'm gonna start to slice it. So just add some on the bottom of your form. Let's sit here. A little more to this side, and bring your chocolate over. It's not that hot anymore, but it's not that cold either. So I'm just gonna use a glove for this ball to hold. Look how beautiful the chocolate is. So just pour this into your form on the top of your cashews. Try to turn around so you can all see. Try to use this kind of spatula. These are the best to get most of the stuff out from your bowl when you try to scrape them out. The flat is the best. Okay, I guess I got it all. The rest I'm just gonna taste. So just even them out. as much as you can. And now what I'm gonna do is, I left here a little bit of cashews, so I'm just gonna put them into my chocolate fudge. Guys, it looks so good. Just gonna try to get the bigger pieces. Not gonna get the little crumbles. That's it. And then just stir it a little bit around into your fudge so you get them inside as well. Now all we need to do is just wait for it. Don't close it. Use this plastic wrap underneath so you can take it out easily when it cools down properly. Put it in the freezer for about an hour and then take it out and put it back in the fridge, or you can even start slicing it. Hopefully it's gonna be done in an hour. Not before an hour, don't take it out. So, into the freezer, 1 hour, and then we're gonna slice it. After I put my chocolate fudge into the freezer for 1 hour, I took it out, and it's really nice and hard. So now I'm just gonna take it out. I'm just gonna flip this form over. Oh, it just came out by itself. Look at that. So that means it's success. Gonna just take off the foil. I'm not gonna take the whole thing off because I just wanna cut a few slices to show you how nicely it came off. Just gonna cut into them. They look so fine. Gorgeous. Just transfer it for your to your plate. And nicely turn them over. See? Beautiful. Get my hand from chocolate. Looks amazing, guys. A real party pleaser. Enjoy.